and gentlemen, the Record of Ragnarok anime is finally upon us. By the time that I'm recording this, the Record of Ragnarok anime should air tomorrow on Netflix on June 17th, bro, and I am so hyped to finally get to watch this. This is definitely one of my most anticipated watches of this year, man. And the crazy thing is, and I still can't believe that I'm saying this, but I have read the manga for Record of Ragnarok. I actually made a video talking about the manga Record of Ragnarok. If you guys haven't checked that out, make sure to go check that out if you want to see my actual thoughts like over the course of the series itself, because I am caught up, man. But yo, just getting to see all the fights animated and the characters with voices and whatnot, it's just in the music. I fucking love the music in the trailer so much. The opening, the ending, the OST, everything sounds so hype. Just it's, bro, I'm losing my goddamn mind out here. But now, I'm not gonna lie, when I watched the first trailer for the Record of Ragnarok anime that dropped, me and probably a bunch of other people, we were mad skeptical, man, because, you know, Studio Graphnica, the studio that is animating it, we haven't really seen too much of them, you know. The only notable thing that I've seen from Graphnica is Hellsing Ultimate, which I think is really, really good. They had a part in animating that. But other than that, dude, there's nothing really standoutish that I can really, you know, pick out that Graphnica has done, at least in my opinion, of course. So seeing them animate that, already, you know, there's some skepticism here and there. But when I saw the trailer, you know, there's some CGI here and there, which, you know, obviously a bunch of people won't like, but, you know, what you can, you know, what can you do about that? You know, there's a lot of still animations and whatnot, and that's kind of what's throwing me off. You know, I was scared that they weren't going to do this anime, or this series, I guess I should say, justice, because obviously this series is literally tournament arc the anime. Oh, you have to animate the fights good. If you don't animate the fights good, I mean, there is no Record of Ragnarok without the fights, am I right? So of course, when it dropped, you know, me and a bunch of my friends, we were, you know, analyzing it and whatnot, hoping to God, you know, keeping our expectations low. Maybe it won't be as hype as we're making it out to be. And then the second trailer dropped. When the second trailer dropped, that's when the hype, like, just got injected into my veins, because they had some dope ass shots that I loved, bro. That boy Adam in Eyes of the Lord, dude, it just looks so good. You know, that man Sojiro is looking nice too. Poseidon, everyone looked really, really good. Of course, my girl Brunhilde, you know, you can't forget about the waifu right there. Best girl, by the way. Everything was looking real nice in that trailer. I'm not gonna lie, dude. Like, that's the trailer that I've low-key been re-watching a lot lately. And I feel like the skepticism that I have is kind of gone, because I honestly feel like all I expect is at least decent to average animation, bro. I don't need no ufotable Mappa type levels for this shit. I don't know. I guess it's a little bit of part of me that I've read the manga already, so obviously I already know the outcomes to every fight and whatnot. I know the characters, their backstory and whatnot, their motivations, their drive. So in my opinion, like, there's nothing that they can surprise me with, you know. Like, we've seen some cool ass shots, you know, with Thor, Lubu, Adam, Zeus and whatnot, Poseidon, Sojiro, all that shit. Like, it looks dope as hell, like, already. So in my opinion, all they gotta do is have at least just decent animation, and I'm gonna think it's fire, honestly. I'll just think it's fire. Now, it's kind of crazy, like I said before, this is the first anime that I'm ever watching that I'm going into with knowledge already from the manga, dude. And in my opinion, it's low-key, like, making me even more hyped for it. And I thought whenever, if I ever did this, I thought I'd low-key, you know, I guess be a little less interested since I know everything. But honestly, I guess it's since it's Record of Ragnarok, and since its story isn't really its, you know, its main grabbing point. You know, like I said, you know, Record of Ragnarok is all about its fights and its character backstories. But, you know, the story, it's just there. You know, it kind of just, we're fighting gods versus humans. That's all you really need to know. So I guess maybe that kind of plays a part in it. But honestly, dude, regardless, I'm still gonna be so hyped to watch this on Netflix, dude, when it drops. Now, Record of Ragnarok, I guess in the series itself, it does have a lot of hype around its name. It has a really cult following. But I'm gonna be honest, you know, I guess, like, coming from animes, I guess, like, anime only perspectives, there is not really a lot of traction around it. I really hope when the anime comes out tomorrow, I do hope that, like I said, Graphnica does pull through. The animation is at least decent, average, you know, above average at best, dude. You know, like I said, I'm keeping my expectations in check. I know a lot of people are saying, like, yo, Record of Ragnarok anime of the year and whatnot. I mean, shit. I mean, we'll see. You know, I'm not gonna try to be on no bias type B right now. But hey, I love me some Record of Ragnarok. You feel me, dude? But I really do hope that a lot more people give this series a try. Maybe, you know, move over to the manga and whatnot. Actually, I can't believe I'm talking like a manga reader out here, bro. This shit is nuts. This shit is crazy. I feel part of the manga community, man. I never thought I'd hear those words come out of my mouth either, dude. But I just really hope that more people do give this series a try, you know, when they premiere it tomorrow, dude. I believe they're only showing the first 3 fights. We did see a little sneak peek, you know, from my Record of Ragnarok people out there. If you know what I'm talking about, if you know, we did see a little sneak peek of the 4th fight, bro. But hey, all I'm hoping, dude, is that a lot of people do give this series a try. It gets the popularity, or I guess the traction, the hype that it deserves, because it is definitely worth your time to check this series out, man. I do hope that they do continue it. Like I said, we haven't even watched the first season of it, I guess. And I really do hope they continue it, though, because I'm going to be honest, the fights after the 3rd fight, it just keeps getting better and better and better and better, bro. So, man, tomorrow is going to be a great-ass day. But everybody, I think that's going to be it, man. I do plan to make, you know, obviously more videos on Record of Ragnarok. You know, I definitely want to see if the anime meets my expectations or it doesn't meet my expectations or it exceeds my expectations. But I guess we'll see tomorrow, right? But yeah, everybody, like I said, dude, make sure to leave in the comments down below. Let me know what you guys are most excited for in the Record of Ragnarok anime and whatnot. Have you even heard of Record of Ragnarok and whatnot? And, you know, like, just let me know what you think about the series in general, guys. But yeah, make sure to leave a like, guys. Subscribe, hit that bell, follow me on Twitter, all that shit, and follow me on Twitch as well. But other than that, guys, it's been your boy Ivory. Hope you have a great ass day today, and I'm out. Peace.